let me show you one of the best text-to-speech systems that's available as of now. It's called Murf AI, and I'm gonna show you how to use it right now. Let me show you how easy it is to use Murf AI. Now, if you wanna check it out, link will be provided in the description. Now let's jump over to my Murf dashboard. So in my Murf dashboard, I'm able to view all my projects that I've used. So in this case, I can create a new project, save these in folders, or invite team members to help me out with these projects. So in this case, let's start with a new project, and I'll say V2 for this, and I'll keep it in my folder. I have the option for audio and video. In this case, I'll use audio, and I'll start from blank. You can select any of the ones you want from here. So let's go ahead and create a new project. Now, to get started, it's gonna load in the Murf editor. Now, in the editor, first thing I wanna do is show you the voices that's available. So let's go into Explore AI Voices. And in this section, we're able to preview the voices before we actually use them. Now, there's several languages available, including English, Spanish, Dutch, Russian, Turkish, etc. You can select in any of these and preview the voices for each one of these. So in this case, let's start off with the English ones. And if I click play, we're able to hear a message for them. So let's hear it.
It only takes one voice at the right pitch to start an avalanche.
Okay, so that's Tarril. There's also Natalie.
Introducing Perfect Meal, a special formula for your feline.
Okay, let's try out Ronnie.
We know it's such a drag having to take the bus to work.
Okay, so once you hear these, you're gonna see if you like it or not so you can use it. Now, we can filter these out by male, female. There's also age groups, so if you wanna have someone that's young or maybe a kid, well, you can select it. For example, Grace.
I can narrate children's books or convey holiday wishes to...
That sounds pretty cute, right? So there's a male if you wanna have a male kid or if you wanna choose all the groups. Now, there's also filters here that are pretty interesting because you can select it by use case depending on what you want to use it for, because obviously, if you're gonna use it for documentary, you want someone who has that tone of voice for documentary, okay? So let's go ahead and select Tarril for now, okay? And we can go ahead and start writing here something and it'll transcribe it into text into speech, right? If you want to do that. Now, in this case, I'm gonna transcribe one of my videos and I'm gonna put it in here. So let's go ahead and go into import script. I'm gonna select the file. Oh, and by the way, you can import a TXT, a doc, or an SRT. The SRT files are the transcripts that come with timing, and I'm gonna show you one right now. So let me go ahead and select this one. This is from a video I made. I'm gonna bring it in here, and it's gonna load in all the text, including the timeframes for this, okay? So here we go, it loaded it in. It's using this voice from Tarril. Now be aware, we're getting a message on the left. Since this is an SRT file that comes with timing, I'm getting some warnings, and why is that? Well, let's say that this first sentence normally is 6.57 seconds. And the voice that I selected for Tarril is 9.10 seconds. So that's why I am getting this warning. Why is this important? Because if you're gonna use this SRT file to load it in on a video that you have already, then you need to consider speeding up the voice or selecting another voice that talks more faster, okay? So in this case, I'm okay with these warnings. And we're able to preview this. So let's go ahead and select.
Get ready to be more productive with your team and save time with this browser extension. You are going to...
Okay, so this guy talks pretty slow for this kind of video. So I speak fast. So let's select someone else. I'll select the female for this. I'll go crazy. So Natalie, how does Natalie sound with this transcript?
Get ready to be more productive with your team and save time with this browser extension. You are going to accomplish that.
That's how easy it is to transcribe text to speech. Now, like I said, there's sentence by sentence. In this case, I've selected Natalie for this one. I can select someone else for this other one, and I'll go ahead and select Charles, and I'll go crazy and select Ronnie for this one, and I'll keep Tarril for the fourth sentence. This is just for testing. Obviously, if you have several people speaking in a transcript, well, it's a good idea to switch between them, okay? So we're good to go. We're gonna use this for this purpose. Let's go ahead and click okay. So now they're loaded it in and you can see I have one voice for each one of these sentences and then the rest is just Tarril, okay? Now, what else can I do with this? Okay, so if I select this, I can change the promo style to conversational. It could be the pitch if I wanna change the pitch. So if I go higher or lower, I can change the speed for this if I wanted to speak faster or slower. Add a pause in some of these sections. I can also emphasize in some words. So So for example, productive, I can go ahead and emphasize that, and extension. Okay, so I've emphasized these just for testing purposes. Again, it's gonna load in, so it converts that text to speech really quickly. There we go.
Get ready to be more productive with your team and save time with this browser extension.
Okay, so maybe that emphasize was too much. Again, I can edit that if I like. I can make it lower. It's like emphasize, but not too much. Okay, keep it a little bit simple. I can apply it, and again, it's gonna reload, right? Now, once I'm ready, I like the voice that I've added. I have my text ready. What else can I do? Well, we can import media. So if I wanna add media from here, I can import my own, or I can select from the ones that's available as of now. I'm gonna add some stock photo here, video. I'll select this one. Again, just for testing purposes, I'm gonna add it to the timeline, and I'm gonna stretch the timeline here, and you can see the videos added there. I can add a second video, a third one, a fourth, etc. I can add some music to this, so I can select something from, I don't know. Okay, let's select this one. Go next. Let's add it to the timeline. Okay, here we go. So here's the voice, the video, and the music. Okay, let's lower the voice for this. And I'm gonna click on the volume mixer. And for the music, I'm gonna lower it kind of there. Again, you gotta test it, see what you want higher, lower, etc. The video, I'm gonna remove the audio. I don't think it has audio, but if it did, it's gonna remove it from there. Okay, so in this case, it's only the speech and the music, it's gonna be low. All right. I can also work with the video settings here if I want to change it to, let's select square one, 1080 by 1080p, and I can turn subtitles on. So in this case, I'll turn it on, and let's go ahead and preview this. Okay, so I just finished the render for the preview. I'll go ahead and click play.
Get ready to be more productive with your team and save time with this browser extension. You are going to accomplish that.
Now, I'm a sucker for time savers, so I'm really liking this deep.
Okay, did you see that? Now, obviously, the transcript has nothing to do with the video, but I can make a whole video with a transcript, with something generated from AI, etc., and create text-to-speech with video and start publishing on YouTube, Facebook, for ads, etc., without me having to be on the video. So some people might be shy on video, so this is a great option to do this. Now, once you have it the way you like it, with the voice, the videos, images, the music, etc., you are good to go with the export. Now on the export, you have the option to export a video. So MP4, move, and include subtitles in the video, download YouTube codes, etc. Or just the voice only. And then you have the options for voice. So you can select the type of voice, the format, download as, the quality. In my purpose, I would choose high. You want the highest quality, obviously. And the channel, stereo or mono, voice plus music, and script. So you have all these options available to start exporting your files and using it the way you like. So if you want to use just the voice, go ahead and grab this and download. The export is gonna start and you are good to go. You have a text-to-speech system that is really good with the voice that you selected and all the tweaks that you made to it. But there you go, that is Murf AI. I mean, it's super easy to use. So I do recommend, go ahead and check it out. Like I said before, the link will be provided in the description. And that's a wrap for Murf AI.